Today we will learn how route bridge is elected in STP. The election of route bridge is based on bridge ID, which is the combination of two things. First is priority and second one is MAC address. Switches having lower MAC address and lower priority will become route bridge. By default, all switches have priority 32768, and we can verify it by using show spanning tree VLAN 1 command. Now it will show that the priority of switch 1 is 32769. It is because in case of VLAN 1, the actual VLAN ID is added to the default priority and it will become 32769. Similarly, we can verify the priority in switch 2 also by using same command show spanning tree VLAN 1, and it will show that the priority of switch 2 is also 32769. If both switches have same priority, then the decision of route bridge is based on MAC address, and you will see that the MAC address of switch 2 is 000E.3889.C480, and the MAC address of switch 1 is 009.43E4.2700, which is lower than switch 2. That's why it becomes route bridge. Now we can't change the MAC address of any switch, but we will change route bridge by changing the priority of the switch. If we will change the priority of switch 1 and make it higher than switch 2, then switch 2 will become route bridge, and we can change the priority by first moving to the configuration mode, then spanning tree VLAN 1, then priority, and if we put question mark, it shows the range of priority we can use, and it will 0 to 61440. But there is also a message that bridge priority must be in increment of 4096. So here I am using 40960. Now the priority of switch 1 will change, and we can verify it by using show spanning tree VLAN 1. Now it will show us that the priority of switch 1 become 40961. Now we will see in switch 2 by using show spanning tree VLAN 1 command. We can see that switch 2 becomes root bridge as it has lower priority than switch 1. And this is the basic configuration of root bridge election in STP. Thank you.